So today, of those three people...
You won't be seeing
open. I'm aware. That's a long commute. So, anyway, today's lecture topic, I wanted to talk about reductions versus invasions. When do you decide to do which one? Because I bet some of you guys have done it wrong before. Well, just guessing. Right there, Brooklyn's going. Yeah, me. So what? So first of all, what is an invasion? What does that mean? I can even put some stones up if it helps the discussion. I guess the black stone should be up here. So, super simple, right? I've seen patterns like this before.
So, territory inside your opponent's jurisdiction.
Yeah. So basically, usually on an invasion, it's an attempt to live within your opponent's sphere of territory. What's a reduction?
To reduce.
Well, they both reduce territory, right? Because if I live here, my opponent doesn't give us territory.
To reduce from the outside.
So meaning usually I'm going to play to escape to the center. But they both usually accomplish the same thing, right? Which is usually take away opponent's potential for territory for points. So they both have this similar relationship in that they're accomplishing the same goal. But they're very different in terms of how they actually play out. All right, so in this situation, let's say it's black's move. So give me an example of a invasion move. What would you play if you want to invade? Lots of good options.
3-3.
Hey, that's a classic invasion. You guys already know that one, right? Super smart. Okay.
16-13?
Like here?
No.
Oh, wait, 10, 11, 12, 13? Oh, this one. This one is kind of half and half. This is kind of a weird move, right? This is both kind of a half reduction, half invasion. And I say, when I look at this one, I say it's half and half. I know this because I've seen moves like this before. I know how they end up. But this stone isn't really the most useful stone for living down here, nor is it the most useful stone for getting out, believe it or not. It looks like it's kind of safe. It's kind of on both worlds. We usually don't see a move like this because it's not really aiming at anything directly. It's very wishy-washy. And in general, I'm just going to generally try to discourage you from playing moves like this, like fourth line in between two stones without a real aim. It's usually your opponent's going to decide whatever your opponent wants to get, and you're going to have trouble doing whatever, you know, any one thing. In this case, white will probably just say, all right, I want the corner points. Now what do you do with this stone?
I'll let everything sing a lullaby.
Yeah, you could say, sing a lullaby. Be like, okay, little guy. And then go play somewhere else.
Yeah, I
would not do. No, you wouldn't play?
No, I wouldn't play safe places. Maybe out of hand loop or something.
Yeah, I mean, but it's tough to know what to do with the stone, right? It doesn't have a good aim after this. So usually other invasion moves are going to be things like this. This looks very normal, right? In this case, it's actually an invasion. Why is it an invasion? Yeah, we're on the inside of white. We want to live here, right? We can live here. No points for white there. This is another really key invasion point. Notice it's the same relationship as this one, right? So you can do the same thing to this stone, too. It's also the weak point, or one of the weak points for this stone. So also a key invasion point. If your opponent is being really mean and trying to take lots and lots of territory, and you're willing to be really flexible, you can play a move like this. The suke attachment. You attach right to this stone and say, all right, do something, white. Wherever you go, I'm going to go to the other place. If white comes here, black actually has three good moves, four good moves, maybe depending on ladders and things. But where would you play? Four good moves. What are your options?
Cross cut.
There's one. This is just like direct fighting. This is usually going to end bad without any other extra support. If this is all white has some lots of potential, but hey, it's a move. And if we have ladders, very playable. Extend, like this. This is definitely a move. This is perhaps the most simplest. White blocks this way, so you're gonna go this way and eat these points. Pretty easy. Two more moves.
Maybe
17-13. You're doing it this way. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 13. 10, 11, 12, 13 here?
No,
Here? Not in love with this move. Where do you think white's going to go?
Okay.
I like that move. I like that move a lot. Yeah, I mean, let's take these two stones off the board. We exchange these two, right? Even exchange. So if this stone is kind of like this stone was here, and you decide to play here, it's not terribly helpful yet. You're still surrounded by white. You don't have a whole lot of prospects. And we put these two stones down just for fun. You're kind of broken, right? You don't have a lot of potential. White's already blocked you. White's almost killed this stone. You don't have a lot of space to run this way. Tough, tough for black. So the other two moves, Angela?
What about on 9, like one.
Right here? That's a nice one. Basically, you know, one of the ideas when you're invading, is your stones are already weak. So a tactic is, well, let's make them even weaker. I know that sounds stupid, but basically,
your stones are weaker, so you're going to
allow there to be weaknesses. Like, you're saying, I know my stones are weak. If you want to take advantage of that, be my guest. But the second white takes a move like this, there's either two options. You can either become stronger, right? Now you're threatening to capture this stone or this stone. You guys see this? If white comes over here and tries to protect this stone, you go Atari, Atari, kill. Or if he connects, you just go Atari, kill. So that's something super fancy like this. But now, white has lots of defects, right? Only three liberties here, only two liberties here, three liberties here, and there's an Atari. So even though your stones are looking like they're still gonna die, don't be emotionally attached to them. They are not your children. They're just gonna give you lots of free moves later on. Okay, so these are...
Your black had to respond to this white.
It really depends whatever everything else is on the board. There are several options. You know, even something like approaching over here will be playable. And if we can get another move, if white responds something like this, you know, we can get moves like this. And then like this. And white's still really weak. Very, very
back up there when you played on the 6-4, whatever.
6-3?
17 there, yeah, the black stone there, when you play it there, white responds on the side because otherwise you get.
Well, it feels like if white plays here,
yeah,
it still has a lot of the same problems.
Yeah. But right. You also, is black could also take the other side now and get something else?
Yeah, black could still come over and, you know, do stuff in the corner. I mean, this. So I can just play that right away. You're like, corner's mine.
Yeah, so white playing over there is something that what?
It really depends on the direction of the wind. I mean, if the board is this open. If white doesn't know if there's no other stones over here, I'd have to think about it, read it for a while. But certainly this is playable, but you got this in for free. This will be useful to help capture these two stones. Mm-hmm. Because right, you can turn here, and if white doesn't want this double Atari, you know, that's a pretty useful move. So there's fighting, okay? And even though you're in the middle of white's influence, you know, I want you to think of yourself as like the 2-year-old toddler who doesn't know any better. He's just going to go and mess everything up in this nice, clean dining room. And as long as you can keep some mud sticking to the curtains, you've done a good job. Okay? But don't be attached to your stones on invasions like this. When you just throw caution to the wind and just, you know, go to make a mess, don't be attached to your stones. Okay, just look for free stuff. Get as many free moves as you can. Okay, as probably a little further I want to go in terms of possible invasions in this setup. Are there any good reductions in this setup? I think a way to reduce your opponent, not invade? Not really. Why not, David?
Come down the side.
It's too high.
Everything is high. Okay, and this is the major determining factor when you're going to reduce or you're going to invade. There's one other factor we're going to talk about for determining which two. But basically, if your opponent's stones are all high, right, all on the fourth line, you're far more likely to start invading. If your opponent has stones, or even just a single stone on the third line, There's actually a really common pattern here in this case. Do you know what black should do?
Yeah.
Black wants to reduce. Do you know? We're just going to press white down. And if we can keep white low, we might even be able to get to build up a wall here. And we're not just looking at this potential for ourselves, we might be looking at all this for ourselves if we can keep white low. So if white doesn't want to get pressed down, you know what the most common response is when black caps like this, presses white down from the top? You guys are going to learn so much. 9:15 here. Oh, 9:15. I should know. 17:15. What? 15. This one.
Yeah.
Ah, playable. Not absolutely normal, but playable. However, there's a problem with this. Black is going to play here. You going to play here? You know where black's next move is?
I see there's no sequence.
Yeah, two options. Black can just connect. Again, black is now building a wall, a pretty, you know, large piece of influence. Black can still attach here and just reduce all this. And if black doesn't even have to play this right away, black could go here right now and say, oh, I reduced you and you defended this side. And so because of that, it's time to invade your corner. And the more common sequence you see, black tries to reduce, the more common move is actually this one. It doesn't make black stronger. And if white plays here, where's the next black move? Invade. 1-2 punch, reduce, invade. Right? Make white commit to trying to take some territory, and then once white does, invade. Like over here?
Yeah.
Yeah, like you want to put a black stone somewhere over here?
That would be good.
Yeah, white doesn't have a stone. It's not important yet. This can be a lot of points. This is 30 points right here, right? Not anymore. White hasn't put any more stones over here. So at any time, I can just put a stone here and just ruin this. And this stone actually, even though it looks like a weird attachment, this is actually very common to Tsuji. And it works very well with this stone. Because if white tries to cut it off like this,
there's no way.
You cut back, and you can break through it. If white cuts it off like this, it's a little more complicated. If you are committed to invading at this point, you can actually play here as well. And when white cuts, you can take these very, very crude-looking ataris, but you can actually start making eye shape very easily. Or, when white plays here, and if you want to keep everything very light and just keep reducing, you can actually just play this. And, you know, white might try to cut you off, but the result, you can even play here, this is a little heavy, but playable. You're still going to get a wall this way, and white still doesn't have these points yet. White still needs another move. And if white says, no, those are my points, you go, okay, I invade. Right, so the second you get your opponent to commit to something, if there's an opening to invade, you can invade and take it away. Feeling good? Let's look at another possibility. I do have a couple examples from pro games I want to show you too, so you can see that I'm not lying. This is actually how it works. Let's do give black a few more stones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. Here we go. All right, black move. Here, I'll do two more. Okay. Black move. I just made this up.
The center is looking kind of big.
Center is looking big.
But one of the things I notice with my games is I get focused on something. I'll say, oh, there's this big moya going to that. And then at the end of the game, what do you know? White's got all the space across the bottom of the board there.
Yeah, so we don't want to give white all this. This is a lot, right?
Yeah.
I mean, you could actually say it's even a little bit bigger than what Black has.
I haven't even challenged him in the end of the game. He's got it all.
Yeah. So that was the time jump where he must reduce or he must invade.
So
we are at a decision point.
So that big open emptiness in the middle, ignore it.
You want to play this?
No.
Good.
No.
This is not. I mean, no one can say it's absolutely wrong, but it's not. It doesn't feel right. It doesn't feel like we're doing multiple things at once. You're just saying, hey, I want a stone there. Maybe I'll make some territory here, maybe I won't. In Go, we want to find moves that accomplish more than one thing. And in this case, we want to find moves, I think, that actually help out our middle. Like, John's noticing, hey, I can develop this. Look at all these high stones. Black can actually make something really big here.
Could we pressure the stone on my side of the
team? We sure can. Absolutely.
I also really want the gap down the...
Does it still make sense to attach underneath on that middle stone on the fourth line?
Oh, over here?
Yeah.
Probably that's too strong for white.
Yeah, I mean here's the thing. What do you think white's going to do?
White will push that strong way.
Probably connect on the left side.
How do you connect?
I'd rather attack on the left side.
Attach on the left? Yeah, it looks good. And if we just run like this. Oh, I didn't show you the fourth move. We only got the three moves, right? You guys want to remember when we did this shape? The four options, right? We said cross cut, extend, pane. Fourth move is here. This is another way to cause trouble. You're causing trouble. You're looking for free moves. You're looking for free stuff. Okay, but it's another way. Let's say we do this. And white plays here. What do we do next? Make a base like this?
Yeah.
Looks good, but is it? We're still getting attacked a little bit, right? White still has ways to mess with you. So you say, okay, I'm gonna add another move. And actually knowing what move to add is actually really hard. We could play this. Yeah, we actually really, we helped out white quite a bit over here, and we helped white over here.
We started the pressure there and then that one.
No idea. Angela has an idea. What say you?
Let's start out with this intense rate of center for JJ.
Okay. JJ wants.
The white zone.
How?
This one.
Just tap it? There's something I really don't like about this move.
Let's focus.
What do you think about this move I don't like? I mean, it looks like we accomplished. It looks like we built our center. It looks like, you know, we're reducing white. That's all good stuff, right?
Actually, force white become stronger.
Yeah, white actually has a defect here, right? There's actually, we could invade here anytime. White stones are too far apart, right? Three spaces, two stones, too far. So when we play here, where do you think white's going to go?
So we're making white stronger.
Yeah, we just fixed white's weakness for white. That wasn't very productive.
And also
now, there are players who might say, well, if you can play this next and you can turn this into 50 points, sure, it's okay. That's okay. It's okay to fix white's weakness. But if you're not going to make 50 points there, and I'm kind of skeptical that we will, I mean, possible, but not assured, right, that we're going to make 50 points there, this is probably too big to give up, right? We just ruined a potential weakness we could take advantage of.
Could you still invade? John, on the second line there?
Second line?
Right where you're about to put it.
Here?
Yeah, right there.
Well, you should play a third line, right?
Well, I mean, after his play.
Oh. So here?
Yeah, or potentially after you play that high stone.
That's not a fun looking invasion for us.
I was thinking after.
Even if we just play the simple move, you would like to run this way? We block. You'd like to run this way? Yes, we could play there. But then it's honey.
No, you can make those black pieces black so you can jump to another side. Yeah, and then he answered this.
Jump here?
That white turn.
White place here? Tell me. I don't know what you're
Maybe, like, he played over here. Maybe we can do something more.
Yes. So, okay. Yes, very good. Okay. So I think what Z-Way is saying that let's pretend that we didn't do this first. If we have a stone here, and a stone here and a stone here, yes, now there's weaknesses. Without any other help, we need help, is I guess the moral of the story. So in this shape, at least white's quite strong, without any other black stones up for it. So can't invade right away, have to play other moves. But this is still a bad exchange for us, right? White's actually going to cut us off in the middle once we do something right now, and the stone might be left all alone. So it feels like a liability almost.
Yeah, at that point, with white coming out, white looks like he's going to make a run all the way through that.
Oh, yeah, if we try to build something there, white can just poke a hole in it. So what are the other ideas?
Invade.
Where?
That spot on the 17 line.
Right here? This is possible. This is not the move that I would play here, but I bet if there was a really strong player who came tonight and professional, they might disagree and say, this is the best move. Please do that to me.
You tease
them. I know. So this is a good move.
You're like, why is he here? Don't play
him. But here, let me show you why I don't want to play here. Let me show you why I think it's a bad idea. Now, pro might disagree and say, oh, it's fine. But what happens now? Angela doesn't want to look. Yeah, so in Go, the most efficient way to make territory is to make a box. And what is white making? A big old box. This is actually quite efficient. And you can imagine if white gets another move, maybe there, and another move over here. Yeah, that is almost 80, 90 points.
Almost invisible?
No. Actually depends on the fate of this stone.
What if that stone goes away? Would black consider we invade that big corner, that quarter?
Again,
corner?
It depends. If this is a strong stone, yes, we can still invade. If this stone is weak, it's really tough. So your stones on the outside, you can actually use to your benefit, right? Because if this stone is super strong, here, let me add some other stones here. We can start playing moves like this. This stone actually helps this stone. It's really weird, right? If you're double-digit Q and you're not figuring out how all your stones are connected on the board, but you know that they are, these two stones matter a lot. White actually has a couple options here. Here's the most simple one. Let's take the corner. Black can't make a base here, right? Well, what if we play here? Now, if we don't want to let these two stones link up, we can play something like this or like this. But now black plays here. So we're giving white too many things to worry about. White can't get everything. And if white says, oh, you can't connect, I'm gonna eat you. Now we cut. White says, no, I'm hungry, I eat you. And now we Atari. And white says, no, don't eat me. Now we're broken through.
So it wasn't so much like that one black stone up in the above was actually going to help make life in the corner, but it was an alternative.
Yeah.
So it's like, let me have this or I'll take
Yeah, you're asking a question.
Yeah.
You're saying, hey, I've got two or three good ways to go. Which one do you want to take away? Whatever one you take away, I'm happy going the other way. We have to have a plan when you do this. So, anyway, let me go back a step. We get sidetracked really easily. I get sidetracked really easily. This is my problem. But I want to show you all a move. This is a move you need to have in your vocabulary. This formation, when you have a Shimari here, right? Bum bum. You guys have seen this before, hopefully. Very strong formation. When white has a stone here and a stone here, this is called a double wing. Have you heard this expression before? We're learning. Good. Some people, yes. Double wing. This sort of double wing formation has a just classic, just perfect reduction point. How do we, this is all white's potential, right? This could all be really big as we saw in that last example. What is the magical reduction point to make all this smaller?
17.
17, 13? That's an invasion though, right? Not a reduction? Ah, I like Angelo's idea. Again, remember, flexibility, right? Threaten to do two things. White can only do one, you take the other. So we're looking for moves that do two things. 15, down here? There, that's the move. You have to know this move in your vocabulary. Whenever your opponent makes a double wing, and has, especially if they have additional stones helping out the formation, very risky to invade, right? When we invaded over here, what happened? Well, we didn't die, but... We helped white get lots of territory. We don't want to help white get lots of territory. We don't mind if white gets a little territory, but we can't give white a lot of territory. Just like here.
The question, some of the adjoining points on that, do they also have similar potential, or is it really strongly just that one?
So there are other options, okay? Other options are here. If this side has more potential than this side, this is the move you play. If this side has more potential for white than this side, this is the move you play. But if it's about the same and you want maximum flexibility, that's the move.
What if the stone is on the third line is actually out of the fourth?
There?
Yeah,
same thing.
Same thing.
Now, in this case, though, we haven't gotten, I mentioned earlier, right, there's going to be, if you see a lot of third line stones, you're probably going to reduce. If you see a lot of fourth line stones, you're probably going to invade. But there's one other factor to consider. The other factor is whether or not you can attack something. Does white have a weakness? And in this case, there's still weaknesses here. So it might change things. It will especially change things if we have, let's say, this is not good go playing, but I just want to put some stones down. Let's say, I don't know, black has something else in the middle. All right, now this changes a lot. Because, see these three stones? Well, how many eyes do they have?
None.
None literally. But the key point is here, black is a lot stronger now. And white, you put a stone there, might actually have a hard time finding eyes. And if we can force white to take an extra move to find eyes or get safety, that means we have an extra move to do what we really want. So in this case, this is actually a bad move.
In this case,
because white is weak here. These three stones are next to a very strong black position. So we want to be severe, we want to punish. You know, you have to teach white a lesson. And if you don't, you're going to lose. Like, this is serious. If you don't take advantage of this weakness, if you don't take advantage of this, and you play soft moves like this, white's next move is going to be here. And as you can see, white's going to very quickly fix the weakness over here and make a lot of points. Too easy on white.
So if you play that move on 17, yeah, somewhere there, then white will probably try to defend this weak move.
Like this?
Yeah, and then that gives you reinforcement if you play.
Yeah, I mean, there's a couple of good options here. One option is this.
Yeah.
Right? This could be heavy if white is strong. If we're not strong enough, this could be very dangerous because white might be able to come back and re-attack us. So we have to be very careful when we play this move. But we do have a couple of other good options too. One good option is just to do this. We get out a little bit faster. And we've actually turned our invasion into a severe reduction. That's pretty good. It's like we got this for free. That's sweet. Another move is possible is here. This is a cool move. It's like we're inviting white to cut us off, but now we get free stuff, right? There's lots of weaknesses in white. So, and if white plays here, we laugh at white's shape first because white made
empty
triangle. And again, the same thing, depending on, we could actually come back and play right here. And now this stone already has a couple friends. You know, they're not the best friends. They're a little sad. They've been hurt a little bit, but they're still very light. And this stone is actually going to be a lot stronger because of it. So, you guys, all right, so actually, let's go back to our original They're. So we play here. What do you think White's gonna do? Let me show you at least one or two of these patterns, because if you do this in your own game and you get this point, you're gonna go, aha, I should reduce you. And the White's gonna do something and be like, I don't know what to do now. Right?
Right.
So what are White's options? What do you think?
16-6
here?
Yeah.
This is classic response number one. I think most pros actually today consider this to be inferior, but if you're playing in other Q games, you'll see this a lot. And pros will still play it, but it means they need help on this side. Right? There's something they're worried about on this side. Or they're just greedy and want these points. Another response. This, no. It's actually this. This one actually has a little bit of a problem. In that this shape is actually bad for White, because there's a lot of defects. And you might not be able to take advantage of them right away, but let me show you what I mean.
There's the shape of the three white stones together there?
Yeah, with a black stone here.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so let's say we put a black stone over here. And White's like, oh, where are you going? I don't want you to live. I hate you. Or, don't run away, I hate you. Right? One of these types of moves. Well, now Black plays a stone here. And watch this shape just sort of crumple. What does White do? Tough on top, right? All right, that's good. Black plays a stone here.
Well, the good news is it looks like White might have White in the corner.
The good news is White didn't die. That's terrible news for White, though. Wasn't White supposed to get all these points? So what does White do? White can play here. What's the problem? Cut. Has to descend. Black has a cool move here.
Connect?
Where?
Just
these two?
Yeah.
How?
17-30. What? Third line up there, just 16. What?
17. Isn't there already a stone there? Oh, sorry, 17 right here. Yes! This is the move. This is a super nice move. Because...
Sure, you can get the corner, but...
Yeah, I mean, do you see these two stones? If White is something like this, these two stones die and Black's out. Game over. White just got shredded. If White comes back here, kill the stone.
Yeah, get the side.
And push up. Can White block?
Yes.
Well, game over. White does this.
Just pull pressure.
Yeah, keep going. Can White block?
Yes.
No.
Game over.
Of course he can block.
White can come out. White's still weak over here. Getting weaker over here. Just got shredded. And it's all because this one defect, that one extra jump left a defect. Can't do it. Can't do it. If your opponent sees that it's a defect, if he knows the shape, and Ryan just sniffs around just a little bit, lots of bad things can happen. Okay. I'm going to show you the best move. What to do if you're White. And this move has become very popular very recently. Like last 5-10 years, it's become very, like, the standard sequence in response to this.
Yeah.
Let's actually go here. And Black has a couple of options, but again, the normal, most basic pattern is for Black to go here, right? It looks like the shape is stupid, right? There's like, I don't know, weird looking connection. Black to go here. Anyone know what White should do? 17, this one.
No, 17.
3-3.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, 3-3 over side.
Oh, I can't remember. 17. Here?
No, he wants to extend the lowest stone to the right.
Yeah.
This one? This looks obvious, right? But most powerful move is here. That's a cool move. So try to push. We actually just block. And this extra stone, this extra liberty, is basically enough to defend against whatever black can do to us. There's actually a lot of reading. You guys can try this later and try reading out these cuts. But black can't actually do anything to us. It all works out. Now it's like hanging by a thread, okay? But we have just one too many liberties with these three stones, so black can't do anything. That's really cool. So instead, black doesn't actually push. Black just plays here directly. This is that thread I was talking about, right? Black has an extra stone now. We have to respond correctly. That's the move. And usually black will play this, sometimes this, but for just reducing this one. Okay, this is your pro sequence. You just learned knight on pro sequence. Should we practice it? David says yes, everyone else is scratching their head. All right, so what did black want to accomplish in this situation? Reduce. Double wing, we want to reduce double wing specifically. So the move?
Nice move.
Right there, what is white's strongest response? Attach this way. Extend, which way? In, right, keep it the shape. White, this is the move. If you play this against another double digit Q, you're gonna stare at this for like 20 minutes. Like,
that's why we have clocks.
That's why we have clocks. But this looks so weird, doesn't it? Like in any of your games, does anyone play a move like this? You play there and he plays there. Never done that? Well, here, it totally works, okay? Just trust me, it works.
But if you're playing the other direction, if you were black and white...
Plays here?
If white decided to do, say, the 4-4, that seemed more cue-ish for me. Yeah. Yeah.
Let's play it.
And then when white does the obvious protect that one way or another, then black is like starting to eat into the...
I mean, this side is gone, right? At this point, black can just play over here and just be like, haha. That's right. We switched together. But the goal was the same, so it didn't matter. Right? Take away white's potential. Cool? Oh, do we finish here? Should we finish out the pattern? Make sure you guys know this. Not necessarily. It helps.
Doesn't matter.
No, but you always get something. So even if you have to give up two stones because you don't have a ladder, you'll still get strong over here and get something else. Ladder will help. Not necessary. What was the move for white? Really cool move. Move for black. On A. White has to come back and fix with an empty triangle. If white does this, have fun. Everyone find the move. Ouchies, don't do that.
What if white is doing thing that probably could make the empty triangle look up on the other side?
On the other side?
Move that stone.
Here?
No.
Oh, all right, let's go back. Okay, here?
Yeah.
Here?
Yeah.
Here?
Now, white thing. Correct. Yeah. So, what if white thing is trying to.
What's black's move?
Yeah.
Here?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now?
Right now?
On the other side. So,
This way. There's still this cut here. So if black can get another stone over here, it starts to make things like this look like Senten. Whereas if this stone's here, white never has to respond ever again. Because if this stone's here, black can start doing things like this. And if white cuts, black can come down. So you can see, I mean, it's not... Yeah, but here's the thing.
Three.
You mean instead of that?
Yeah, when we have the case that he was talking about.
Okay, here's the situation. Here?
Black goes up.
Black goes here. Oh, sorry. Black goes here, yeah.
And white plays on the upper right instead of.
Ooh.
where's he at? The
funny empty triangle.
Oh, this one.
There you go.
Yeah.
And then...
Oh, so when we cut here, why doesn't white play here?
Yeah.
Oh, absolutely white should play here. Without question.
So
but we just gave away a bunch of free points, didn't we? And there's actually still a weakness here. Right? Again, black has a stone here. In the other situation, guys, remember, when I played a black stone here, white didn't care. White cares again. If white doesn't respond, just play there. You want to kill stone? Well, stone kills you. So again, it's about leaving the fewest number of weaknesses, right? It's about making the best shape that doesn't give your opponent any opening. So that's why. I know this looks like it might be slightly more efficient, but it actually just gives black another free move. We don't want to do that. It's almost like they know what they're doing. And it's almost like I'm trying to teach you what they've already taught us. Okay. All right.
Where exactly does black jump out to in the ideal version of this?
Yep, hold on. Stone there, stone there, stone there, stone there, stone there. Like this, white has just fixed.
Yep, and where did black jump
out? There. This is a shape that a lot of Q players don't like to make. Why do you think they not like to make this? It looks really weak. How do you attack it? We cut. This is a terrible idea for white. White should never play this, at least not right now. Maybe this is endgame. How does black take advantage? Atari, which way? This way is going to work out better. All right, so white's an Atari. So where's white go? All right, where does black go? Try again. Where does white go? Where does black go? Oh, we can try again. All right, and now we can play this, or even this again, we can make the same trade. But even if we just make this, we give up 2 stones, 4 points, but we are so much stronger now. Like, that's a super thick wall, right? This white influence is not projecting at all into the middle. It's completely covered it. Super happy the white cut. Thank you, white. Yeah. Okay? So, all right. General rules. Okay, I got my iPad here. I'll show you just a couple of quick examples from 2 pro games. Actually, I won't show you. I will get to the point where one of the players should do something, and I'll ask you what should they do, reduce or invade. It'll be fun. But before we do, let's review basic concepts. You guys have seen some of the patterns. I don't necessarily expect you to have them all memorized, but at least, you know, the idea hopefully will hit you in the head. Like, there's a stone there. I should play that. So when do you expect to reduce? When's more likely you're going to reduce? When your opponent's low. And I'm going to add to this, I'm going to say this officially, when your opponent's strong. If your opponent's strongs don't have weaknesses, you're more likely to reduce. When your opponent is high and or somewhat weaker, what are you more likely to look for?
Invasions.
All right, you want to try finding it in a pro game? All right, let's take down the stones. And I picked 2 games that they get to this point of the game relatively quickly, you know, from the first 10 to 15 moves or so. But at the same time, they're thinking on a whole other level. Well, I think you can understand the reasoning once they've done it, but it may not be entirely obvious at first glance. So here's a game between Yi Cheng Ho, who's a very famous Korean professional nine don, the Stone Buddha. We've looked at a couple of his games before. He's the one who plays, who normally people say he only tries to win by half point. Like, that's his whole game plan, is just win by half point. Seems like he plays very passive.
Gives you what you want.
Exactly, gives you everything. You want something on the board, it's yours. Just give it to you. But again, he's looking for that one little place where you make one overextension, he's going to make you pay for it. But only a little bit, only half point. So, very normal. Looking kind of game. You get a 3-4 over here. 3-4 over here. Anyone know what this is called? Micro Chinese. So we have high Chinese, low Chinese, or sorry, mini Chinese? Not mini Chinese. I don't know, mini Chinese. This is, well, it's kind of weird. It's not in the right. This stone should be here. Modified micro Chinese, I guess. Anyway, he makes that formation. And white plays over here. Where do you think black plays? I know. Yi Chang Hao is white, by the way. And you guys, we don't want to respond to this? No, not at all. So if when we pinch this stone, what are we trying to say? We're saying this is important, and you don't get to be strong here. I don't want you to settle for whatever reason. It can be because you want to develop this. It can be because I don't want you to make points here. Lots of different reasons. But in this case, no, his opponent is actually two, I don't know how to say this, his actual opponent name, Zhaji. I don't know. That's a Chinese professional. Zhaji? Anyway, he plays here. Why not this one? Yeah, low, low, right? We're not making enough territory. High, low makes it difficult for our opponent. Opponent's not sure if we should reduce or invade, and you're ready to deal with both. High stone, low stone. You can go either way. So white plays here. And at this point, black tanuki's here.
Yeah, that's good.
And the reason why black plays this stone is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Some of my students who've been here before know that 5 space extensions are good because your opponent can't invade them cleanly. There's no clean invasion. It's going to be messy. So a little bit difficult. Here, 7 spaces, very easy to invade. So that's why he plays this stone there. All right, so black approaches. White plays here. Some of you have seen this Joseki.
Yeah.
Honey, go back. Here. And white plays a move. This is Yi Chang Ho. Slightly interesting. Normally it's here. Sometimes here. He's a little bit greedy. Like here we threaten to build a lot, but it's short. Here it's very solid, but it's low. And he's saying, I want both. So this has a weakness, but we'll deal with that later. At this point, black says, okay, you have a problem here. You left a weakness. I'm going to invade you, maybe. But before I do, I'm going to take some points and see what you do with these two. And he's saying to white, hey, I bet you can't find a good move that fixes the weakness that you made here because you were dumb, and settles these two stones. No matter what you do, I'm going to be able to find an invasion point or a reduction point or something. And white kind of pretends he doesn't hear him. Let's hear it for it. Anyway, black has a sickness over here. He wants to make use of it. So they play this. And now it is white's move. I'm going to pause the game as me playing it here and let you guys take over. Let's talk about where do you think white should play and why?
One possibility would seem to be about 9-4.
9-4 up here? Oops.
Yeah.
So.
I'm sorry, I don't tell my black. But, if it's good
no, it's white's
black,
move.
Maybe
white's
good for white.
Black, good for black, good for white. So over here?
If it was white, I'd say push down another.
Nah.
Yeah.
I'd say.
It doesn't protect the weakness.
Yeah, there's still a weakness here,
yeah.
Too. So.
Maybe.
It's really hard to find a move. Like, black, you know, when black played this, you know, black was actually being kind of smart and was like, your shape's really weird.
Invade the bottom right.
Yeah,
bottom
left.
Invade down here? Okay, so why? What's your reasoning?
Enclosed.
It's kind of enclosed.
Well, bring because
the space
is still open.
The space?
Yeah.
So you're saying do something like this?
No.
Or like this?
Yeah.
I don't think black's unhappy. White is already pincered, right? Can white make a base here easily?
No.
So that means black's going to play this. Say, run. And this isn't actually the game. They didn't play here. And if white tries to run out, I mean, how do you want to have white run? You want to try this first? We could do this. but it doesn't really guarantee us life yet. Right? Black comes here, you don't have eyes. So we reduced a little bit maybe, but we still have to run. And if anything, we're heavier now, right? Black's just gonna attack us more ferociously. So white can try running like this. And I don't know, we just play there. And what is black getting while attacking this?
So yeah. White instead approaches
this is a trap. You guys see this? Black's like, hey, I'm gonna get a big corner if you don't do something. But if you do something, Black's gonna say, okay, I didn't get a corner. Well, I can die, but okay, I'm not gonna get my corner, but I'm gonna get a lot of points over here and a lot of points over here. So it's kind of like a trap. It's an idea. It's an idea. It's certainly not the worst thing in the world you can do. If you play this move, you're not going to lose your game necessarily.
Approach on the left side.
Approach on the left side.
No, well, I'm sorry. The left.
Of the 3-4 stem.
Yeah.
Like here?
Lower down.
Here. Oh, you want to reduce it?
Yeah, I was seeing.
Now what?
17.
Right here?
No, and
white,
before
the play over there, is
that
13,
17.
This 13?
Yeah, 13, 17.
Right there?
Yeah.
Are you going to make a base right now?
Yeah.
You going to play high? Play low?
High.
Where?
Maybe a little
bit
close.
There? So, invade. Weakness. I attack you.
So low.
Reduce you. In this case, you should actually play high if this goes like this. But the fact that black still has a weakness that he can take advantage of, and white really doesn't now, means this is probably a good exchange for black, because white's left with a weakness. Right? If I play here, this is very difficult. I mean, do you defend? Do you attack? Attack this way? And whatever you do, it's like black gets free stuff, you know?
Yeah.
It's black's gonna have easy time.
Like black can probably play some.
Well, here's the thing. Okay? When you're looking, if you know it's time to reduce or invade, we have to look at what happens when we reduce a low stone. For sure. But even more importantly is if we can make your opponent weak by invading, we gotta do that. Right? Because usually invasion is going to reduce more points, and if as long as we can make something weak, we'll be okay. So is there anything on this board that white can actually invade and make weak simultaneously? We saw it invading here, kind of already too strong, it's too narrow. We're on the run right away.
If that portion is too strong, then it seems to me that above that middle black stone it's equally strong.
Up here?
Yeah.
Is it equally strong though?
I think so.
Yeah, what's easier to invade? This or this?
I think it'd be easier to invade than the bottom.
Hard, but it's not impossible. It's not ruled out.
Sir, and if there's something we can make weak while we're invading,
yeah.
we can still invade five, no problem. I mean, if we're not going to live cleanly, but we're not going to get really punished for it.
17, down one more, right there. Wouldn't that tend to offer you, now white comes out.
We're still getting attacked, right? And black's just going to make points here, black's going to make points here.
Would that be 17, 6?
There?
Some down right here.
Like what? This is probably going to die, right?
But if 17, 8.
That's the move that was played.
Hmm.
So why? Why can white get away with this? We said five space extensions are hard to invade. But why is white, you know, who is, you know, Lee Chang Ho, why does he think he can do this?
And they have a weakness over there too.
These three stones don't necessarily have the eyes you think they have. If this stone ever gets out or becomes alive, it's very difficult very quickly for this to turn into eyes. You see? So this is the point he looked at. Unfortunately for us, it got really messy really quickly. You guys know where Black played? Black looked at the board and said, okay, you're going to attack me.
Oh, thank you.
Double invasion.
So
is that cool?
Which one?
Oh, and actually, I'll show you the next couple moves because they played out one of the sequences I showed you earlier. White plays here?
Yes.
Do you remember this move?
Yeah.
Like that weird jump out, we did it from a different angle. And then white plays here. You guys remember this shape? Yeah, so there's actually several things we can do. In the game, black actually plays here. And when white cuts, black actually just comes here, right? Still looking, eyeing this weakness, right? There's an attachment there to separate or just make a base. Black can even jump out again or Atari this way. I mean, there's lots of things that black can do to be safe. And sure enough, I don't want to play this all out, but basically this just ends up just sort of living right here in the middle of white's territory. They play a couple moves, but actually this stone ends up getting cut off. But in exchange, white basically gets a huge wire. Okay, let's look at another game. If I can remember where it was. I saw earlier today a fairly recent Gu Li game, who's one of the strongest players in China right now. And, oops, scroll, apparently he's played a lot recently. I really should have written down which one it was. I think it's that one. Nope, not that one. Okay, I have dropped, I lost it. iPad.
Maybe I can find one.
You can find one. Well, I had one invasion that was, or it was actually reduction on invasion. I know, I gave it away. All right, well, here's the thing. Let's play some Go. You want to play some Go?
Sure.